In this video, we're going to take a look at how you would use your calculator to compute a derivative. So let's start by, first of all, computing this derivative by hand, and then we'll pull up the calculator and see how it could do something similar. For this function, it's a pretty simple derivative, x cubed minus 5x plus 1. And if you've watched the videos on the shortcut rules, the power rule, sum and difference rule, we can very quickly take this guy's derivative without too much trouble at all. I wanted to kind of keep this example somewhat simple just so we can illustrate the processes with the calculators. The derivative for x cubed minus 5x plus 1 would be 3x squared. That'd be the derivative of x cubed minus 5. That's the derivative of minus 5x. And then the derivative of 1 would be 0. So this is the derivative for f of x right here. All right, now, when we say find the derivative using a calculator, we have to be kind of clear what we mean. Do we mean find the symbolic derivative like this? Like, are we wanting the calculator to spit out a function of x to where when I provided an x as a derivative should, it'll constantly tell me what the slope of f of x is? Or do we just want the numerical slopes at given x values? You know, that's the difference here. And it turns out some calculators have different capabilities. Only a handful of calculators can give symbolic derivatives. In other words, if you were to give it x cubed minus 5x plus 1, there's only a handful of calculators that can give you 3x squared minus 5, the symbolic derivative of a given function. Many, many more calculators can give you numeric slopes. Now that's nothing to sneeze at. That's still very good, but just be aware that not all calculators can give you the symbolic derivative. So which ones can? Well, I'm going to stick just primarily with the TI family for this video. There are other calculators, Casio, HP, that have some similar capabilities, but probably the largest provider of graphing calculators, at least right now, is TI, so I'm just going to stick with these. So some of the ones that can do the symbolic derivatives would be like the Inspire, but there's multiple types of Inspires. This is specifically the one that says CAS, Inspire CAS, because that's computer algebraic system. It can compute things symbolically where just the regular Inspire cannot. The TI-89, the titanium, can do symbolic derivatives, as well as the TI-92 plus. That's the one that has a QWERTY keyboard. So you have to be a little careful because not all of these can be used on like the SAT or, you know, some other standardized test and whatnot. Some instructors allow certain types of calculators, but not other types of calculators. So you have to be a little careful. I will probably do a video on one of these coming up shortly to show how to do symbolic derivatives. But usually what most people have, at least in the classes that I teach, are like the TI-84, the 83, the 86, you know, ones like that. And that's the ones I'm probably going to focus on primarily, how to get these numeric derivatives. So let's say we're trying to find the slope of x cubed minus 5x plus 1, specifically at x equals 2. Now, the T84 plus, that's the one I'm going to start with right now. It can't show me the symbolic derivative, but it can give me the slope specifically at 2. If I define a given x value, it can at least provide me that. So here we go. Here's the T84 plus that you're seeing on your screen right here. And there's two ways to do this on this calculator. Let me start with probably the most standard way. If you take your cursor and you go to the math button, which is right here, and you'll scroll down until you find something that says n deriv. That's the nth derivative of a given function. So there it is on my screen. It's number 8 here. You would just basically type in this function. So it says dd blank. So we're going to take the derivative with respect to x of x cubed, get out of the exponent, minus 5x, there's an x, plus 1. Okay, differentiate this function with respect to x, but then it gives you a bar at x equals, and then it wants a certain place to find the derivative. So plug in a 2, our answer would be 7, right? So the derivative of this function with respect to x at 2 would be 7. That's the slope of f of x at 2. Now, if we had gone back and done this by hand, sure enough, if we had looked for f prime at 2, then 3 times 4 minus 5, that's 2 squared, times 3 minus 5, that would be 7, right? So you can do it by hand, or you can do it using the calculator. And so this is just a pretty straightforward way of doing it. But there's another way to do it on your TI-84 as well. What you can also do is go to the Y equals screen and graph the curve. So we'll graph x cubed minus 5x plus 1. We'll graph that, right? So here's the graph of f of x right here. Now, if I want the slope at 2, here's what I have to do. You see my cursor, I'm going to go to the second calc, and you'll see number 6 right here says dy dx. That's what we know is derivative. So we'll push number 6, and then it'll give you a little trace cursor on the actual function here that you could slide left or right, or you could just type in 2, and you see x equals 2, push enter, and it'll say dy dx, that's the slope at 2, would be 7 there. So that's one way to do it. All right, so next let me show you what you do if you have one of the older style TI-83s, or even the older TI-84s still look like this. So if, you know, here's an old TI-83 here. There's something slightly different when you go to the end deriv. If you'll remember with the newer TI-84s, when you pushed enter, it actually came up with a symbolic d blank dx, you know, ddx, and you typed in your function with a vertical bar. It looked very nice aesthetically. But now when you push end deriv for these older styles, it just gives you, it looks more like code more than what you would actually expect to see. But no matter, we can still do it. End deriv, we can take x cubed minus 5x plus 1. But don't just close it off and push enter, because remember, it can't give you symbolic derivatives. It can give you numeric derivatives. So you need a couple extra things here. Here's your function, comma. We want to differentiate it with respect to x. So you have to do comma x, and then another comma, and where you want the derivative taken, namely 2. So we read in English, you would say this is the derivative of f of x with respect to x, evaluated at 2. In other words, this is f prime at 2. Push enter, and it still gives you 7. So multiple different ways to do this. Now, graphically, it would be exactly the same. I'm actually not even going to do that one here. But if you add y equals, you know, go into y equals, if you type the function x cubed minus 5x plus 1, then second calc number 6 here, that's exactly the same as the TI-84 example we just did earlier. Now, if you want to know how to do derivatives symbolically, if you have an Inspire CAS or a TI-89 titanium or something like that, then look out for an upcoming video where I'll try to do one of those and show you how to do one of those symbolically. So don't think that this is anything to sneeze at. This is still really good stuff. Even though you can't get the symbolic derivative, it is still very helpful. Now, what do you do if you have an 83 or an 84, one of these older styles, and you would like some assistance on finding symbolic derivatives? Well, one thing you can do is to go to this website called wolframalpha.com. It's a fantastic website. You can basically think of it as a massively big calculator plus a lot of different stuff. A few years ago, it was primarily a calculator-based type website, but since then they've expanded to be more like an encyclopedia more than just a calculator. But nevertheless, you've got this Google-ish looking type bar here, and you can just talk to it in pretty much plain English. It's very good at understanding what you're wanting. So if you want the derivative of, you know, x cubed minus 5x plus 1, then you just say derivative of x cubed minus 5x plus 1, push enter, and it'll do a couple things. Number one, it'll obviously give you the derivative, you see 3x squared minus 5, but if you look at my cursor right here, it'll also show you the steps. This is great if you have more complicated derivatives like product rule, quotient rule, chain rule type problems. It can be a really big help here. So as you'll see here, it's going term by term, differentiating each term in the sum, and then simplifying and simplifying down to your answer here. So I know this example I'm doing here is a very, very easy example, but just try to imagine if it was a really, really nasty derivative and you're at home and it's late at night and you can't get help from your teacher. This is a fantastic resource that you can use to kind of help you get over any derivative humps that you might be stuck on.